Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website, that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for December the 13th of 2019, well, it is titled Full Moon Geminids. So what do we see here? Well, this is an image from the 2016 Geminid meteor shower, which occurs about the second week in December. And this is a meteor shower which occurs when the Earth passes through a trail of debris left behind by another object in the solar system. And this is often a comet that leaves icy debris behind, but it can also be, and in the case of the Geminid meteors, it is actually the case of an asteroid. So an active asteroid that is leaving little bits of debris behind, and those little bits of debris continue to follow the same orbit as the asteroid. And when the Earth happens to pass through that orbit and those orbits intersect, then the Earth will collect those materials and they will strike the Earth's atmosphere at very high speeds and will be vaporized. And that's what we're seeing, is a vaporization trail, as that small tiny speck of material strikes the Earth's atmosphere and burns itself up. Now, if we look at the meteors, and you can kind of trace them back, imagine connecting them all with lines, they would trace back to what we call the radiant point of the shower. And that is the point of the in the sky where they appear to come from. And that is how the meteor showers get their names. The Geminids are, if you trace this back, will go towards the constellation of Gemini. And another prominent shower, the Perseids in August, traces back towards the constellation of Perseus. Now, they really don't come from those constellations. That's just an optical effect. And it occurs because the meteors are all traveling through space parallel to each other. They're following the same orbit. So they all appear to come from the same direction. It's much as a railroad tracks on a flat plane will appear to converge off in the distance. It's the same thing that is happening here with the meteor shower that we see. Now, it's the full moon meteor shower because in 2016, the full moon was present. And you can see that in this image as well. And that's what we have to look forward to over tonight and tomorrow night as a chance to see these meteors. We will be fighting with the full moon as well. And the full moon does brighten the sky. So when the sky is brighter, does it eliminate the meteors? No, they're still there. However, it does make the sky brighter, so fainter meteors will not be visible to the naked eye. It certainly will not blot out the very bright meteors, and you'll still have a chance to see those, especially the early morning hours before dawn tomorrow. But you will not see near as many meteors because the fainter ones will be hidden by the glare of the moon. So you have the chance this coming evening, especially early tomorrow morning in the early morning hours, to see little bits of an asteroid as they burn up in the Earth's atmosphere, giving us a great meteor shower. So that was our picture of the day for December the 13th of 2019. It was titled Full Moon Geminids. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Moonlight Weekend. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.